Hi everyone, hope you all are doing good. So in this video I will talk about resume key points. So many of you asked me, so what key points and how should we make our resume for a fresher actually. So in this video I will try to cover those points so that you can prepare your own resume. I have also mentioned one performer there, so you can have idea like what points you should add and what should be the sequence of it. Okay, so let's begin with it. As you can see here on my screen, these are the main points that you need to add in your resume. It starts with, actually first on the top you have to mention, as you can see here on the top, mention your name, below it address, phone number, email address, all right, and then start and then begin with it. Objective, then academic profile. This is the sequence how it should be. Objective, academic profile, software skills, Microsoft skills, certification if any, and again soft skills and the personal details. Okay, so this should be the sequence as per my research, and I have also made my resume in the same manner. Okay, so let's talk about this is the sequence, and I am gonna talk about the software skill, that is the SAP. What points you should mention there. Okay, so I will share what points I have added in my resume. Okay, so you can add as per your knowledge or your skills. All right, let's see here. That's my first. Okay, under software skills you mentioned the heading, that's SAP Pico S/4HANA SAP beginners profile, all right, and then starts. If you have took any coaching, then you can mention the name of that institute and mention which module you have trained in. So as I have mentioned, SAP Pico. Under this, what are the different configurations and some modules that you have learned throughout this training, or I mean, if you have not took any training, so what are the some modules or what are the some modules or configuration that you know? So you just mention those headings over there. Like I have mentioned, enterprise structure, general ledger accounting, AR, AP, asset accounting, and there is controlling, cost centers accounting, profit center, cost element, cost object, and internal. If you are aware about more topics, then please mention those. Okay, so let's begin with one by one. There are two main module, that is FI and CO. These are two different modules. So under FI we have GL accounting. So under GL, I know how to create GL master, document entry, configuration of line layouts for the display of GL line items, right, and display of GL balances and items. These are the things that I have learned and I know how to do it. You mention your point, what you have learned and what you can do. All right, if you don't know any of these points, then please do not mention anything in your resume which you know and which you are not aware. Please don't mention those things on resume. Then under accounts payable, I have mentioned all these points that I know I can do all these configuration. You mention your part, what you can do under AP. Likewise, AR, asset accounting. My asset accounting is not strong. Actually, I have not practiced it enough. So yes, I have not mentioned much topic under asset accounting. I know the basics. So I have mentioned chart of depreciation, their determination, screen layout, and number ranges and asset classes, and the link of GL. Next comes the controlling. So under controlling, these are the points that I have mentioned which I know in the CO module. Okay, after this, so just make one heading of some module and under these mention the points that you know. Okay, apart from this, then you mention your Microsoft skills. If you are good in PowerPoint, mention it. Excel is most demanding in the company, right? So if you are good in Excel, that is one good point you will be preferred. Okay, and don't think if you are good in SAP then you don't require all of these skills. You will need these MS Excel and PowerPoint in your when you will start working. You will need all of these things. So I will suggest you that have some basic idea. If you are new to this, you don't know, then at least have some basic idea, like how you can create one simple PPT and Excel, basic formulas of Excel and Word. You should know at least all those things. And if there are any other MS skills that you know, then please do mention. Certification, if you have any certificate or given and received, like I from the institute I have done, so I cleared the exam and got the certificate from there. So I have mentioned that here, from that institute. If you have global level certification of SAP PICO, please mention it. Alright. Then soft skills, you can mention ability to work independently in a team environment, quick learning, whatever your soft skill points are. Then mention the personal details, DOB, nationality, father's name, language, passport and marital status. And last, you can mention this declaration. The above mentioned information is true and correct to the best of my knowledge. Alright? Mention your place and name. Okay. So yeah, this was the brief about resume key point that I think you should add, and this is my structure. If and these are the key points a fresher should add in their resume. And please do not add anything in your resume unnecessarily. If you don't know anything, then please don't add on your resume. Because once you are selected, those things will be verified. Okay, so don't just mention anything just for the sake of attention. Okay, so just make simple. Keep your font same. Okay, keep those things in mind while making your resume. And highlight these things and don't use very brighty colors in your resume. So yeah, I think this was the main part that is about the SAP skills that what you need to mention. Otherwise, the rest are the same. Anyone can follow this. If you are not even part of SAP, then you can follow the same structure in your resume, in your general resume, from whatever field you belong to. Okay. And let me know your inputs if you think has it worked for you, and if you need any help apart from this, then please let me know. Please ping in the comment section, and you can also ping me on Telegram link. I usually respond to everyone. Okay, so thank you. This was about